Many riders believe you must replace your motorbike helmet every 5 years. Is this true? Who came up with that figure? Is it dangerous to use a helmet for longer? Let's investigate. It all started years ago with a recommendation from Snell. And let's be clear about this, it is only a recommendation. It always pays to have some healthy scepticism too. Snell has come under criticism before when many believed their standard was making helmet liners too tough and could be causing injuries. Also, Snell made this recommendation with the help of helmet manufacturers who naturally want us to buy more helmets. The most critical part of a helmet is the foam liner made of EPS, expanded polystyrene, which absorbs impacts to reduce injuries and potential death. EPS is incredibly stable and long-lived. One study tested hundreds of helmets, and even after 26 years, the EPS liner was still doing its job properly. Sweat does not affect EPS. The only danger to the foam liner is significant impacts, chemicals, and sunlight. What about the rest of the helmet? The cheek pads and inner liner can wear, of course. And once the fit of your helmet is loose, this is a safety issue. However, most brands will sell these parts. What about the outer shell? If it is intact, no problems. But if it has cracked and is letting sunlight through to that EPS liner, it's time to bin that helmet. What about rust? All metal fixtures are meant to last the lifetime of the helmet. But regular viewers will know rust is a growing problem as some brands are using cheap brackets with a thin rustproof coating that can wear off within months. Ask me how I know. This tends to happen with the brands being made in China nowadays. It should never happen. Insist on a replacement helmet even after the warranty is finished. I spoke with Australia's leading helmet experts about this 5-year rule. They agreed it should not be a rule at all, and that in many cases you can safely use a helmet for much longer than 5 years. However, they did add conditions to this. 1. This assumes you have not had a significant impact that might crush the EPS liner. They believe merely dropping your helmet on the ground is not a problem. But if you have crashed hard enough to daze yourself or get concussion, then replace your helmet. 2. Your EPS liner must not be exposed to sunlight or chemicals. 3. This won't apply to very old helmets. Helmets dating back to the 1970s sometimes did not use the modern EPS liner. 4. Check your helmet regularly. Replace cheek pads and inner liners to retain a good fit. If you see the outer shell, adhesives or resins failing, then bin the helmet. 5. They stressed that the overall safety of helmets has been improving and that wearing an old helmet means you might be missing out on some of the newer safety features like variable density liners or designs aimed at reducing rotational forces. They believe that even the most basic helmets will meet 80% of your protection needs, but if you can bump that up to 90% with a more modern helmet, then why not? In conclusion, the 5-year recommendation by Snell is certainly not a hard and fast rule. And if you forked out big dollars on one of the top helmets like a Shoei or Arai, then personally, I don't see any problem with using it for well beyond 5 years, subject to the conditions mentioned. What's the longest you have used a helmet for? Do you follow the 5-year rule? Keen to hear your thoughts and opinions? Let us know in the comments.